So not only do we integrate training into the dog's life, if you cannot leave the house, or you don't want to leave the house, you have an apartment dog, or you cannot leave the house because the weather is atrocious, then we integrate training into your lifestyle, the owner's. So I had all these little notes around the house. I still have one of them in my office, and it says, "Don't forget Omaha." They were everywhere. They were by the milk in the fridge. They were by the bottle opener for the beers. They were on the toilet. Things that I did throughout the day. If I went to take a leak, I trained the dog. If I went to make a cup of tea and reach for the milk, I trained the dog. Anything I did with Jamie, I trained Omaha. I thought, wow, you know, I've had Omaha for 2 years, and in comes this little baby. He's going to take a dent in the lifestyle, and that's a shame. So I talked to Mimi about it, and I said, well, yeah, there's a number of things I'm going to do. If ever I feed Jamie, I'm going to train Omaha, and I'd like you to do the same. Yeah, we integrate training into your lifestyle. What do? You probably exercise. Good. Exercise with your dog. Whatever you're doing, you're exercising to a video. After each batch of exercises, pause, and the dog can do the same. Sit down, sit down, sit down, doggy down, stretch. Okay? And then you go back again. The point is, he's got to be trained many times throughout the day. Little short training sessions all throughout the day. We've lost quantification. We've got to bring it back. So here's the little exam that we use in puppy class now. Okay, this is a variation from the one presented here. So here's an example of a dog study. These are the scores. Blue is the same test week 1. Red is the same test week 6. 47 puppies. Can you see the difference between the red and blue scores? Did the training work? Yes. This is a simple study, and these are the things that academics will ask. They will ask a question like, do puppy classes work? And to me, they're questions like asking, is chocolate tasty? Is sex fun? I'm sorry, there's some questions where you don't really need to ask them. Do puppy classes work? Yes, duh. But in academics, you have to prove it. There's the proof, and at the back of the room, you can see the difference in the scores. That's what I call wonderful science, because we are talking about behavior change. The old exam was the same as the one you've got here, with the exception that off take it, thank you, take it, thank you was not included, but there was handling. Well, we dropped out the handling. Why? If you look at the handling scores, week 1, they were scoring 75%. Then week 6, they scored 88%. So handling, they scored really well week 1. Of course they did, because they were little puppies. So the handling, yeah, they're doing their job. A really good job, my trainer, so no need to measure it. They are really producing lovely, handleable dogs. So we've now changed the exam to what you've got here. And it is essentially this. Position changes. First hand signals only. Sit down, sit, stand down, stand. The way you're scored is, if you give a second hand signal, it's -1. So the way you fill this in, I'll do it for you as we go along. You just go like this. They give a hand signal to sit, the dog does it, you just circle it. That means it's been done on one hand signal. If they give 3 signals for down, you just put 2. It means they gave 2 extra. So you put down the number of extra signals used. They sit up on one signal, they need 3 to stand, and so on and so on and so on. Okay? Then they lose 1 point for each extra hand signal.